In this tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can use apply modes inside of Continuum's Pixel Chooser to give you more creative options when working with Mocha masks. Now I'm working here in Avid Media Composer, and I have BCC Plus Video Glitch applied, and you can see it's applied to the entire shot. So I'm going to use a Mocha mask to isolate the effect just to the talent here. I've already got this set up. I'm just going to come over and I'm going to turn on the Pixel Chooser. Aha. So now you can see we've got the Mocha mask applied and the video glitch is playing within that masked area. Let's have a quick look at the Mocha mask. And this is a very quick mask created using the Mask ML feature. We have plenty of tutorials on the Boris Effects YouTube channel that cover this in detail. So we won't look at exactly how to do that right now. Suffice to say that it's very quick to do, and it was able to cut this talent out very quickly and intelligently in just a minute or two. So I'm going to close that up. And this particular look is the default or the original look. And this is the post effect look. Okay. So what that means is that the effect is applied, the effect is then masked, and then it's composited back on the background. So this can be useful, but it is cut off. The option below that is pre-effect. So watch what happens when I choose this. Now, I think that is much more useful. So what's happening here is the Mocha mask is being applied, and then the effect is being applied after that. So particularly with this video glitch look, that looks really good. The next option is to have both. So we have the post-effect look and the pre-effect look, which is, you know, still cut off at the edges, but it gives you quite an interesting look there and just gives you another creative option. And this can look different depending on the kind of effect that you're using, of course. Next, we have stacked composite. And this is interesting. This gives us the pre-effect look, but then it composites the mask talent on top of that. So it's kind of like creating an effect sandwich, if you like, where we have the original plate, we have the effected masked area, and then we have the unaffected masked area on top of that. And if I just zoom in here, I'm just going to move down a little bit. You're seeing this white edge here. This is from the Mask ML, and it's particularly obvious. What you can do to control this is use Matte Refine ML here under Mask. Just watch what happens to this area when I switch on Matte Refine ML. Boom, just like that. Haven't had to change any of the settings, and that looks pretty good. Particularly looks great around the hair. So loving that feature inside of Pixel Chooser. Now, beneath Stacked Composite, there's a couple of alpha options. These are particularly useful for editors. The first is Alpha Masked. So that gives you that pre-effect look, but it also gives you a live alpha. You can see I've got a layer below that, this flare light effect layer. So that's particularly handy. And below that we have Alpha Composite. So this is basically the same, but again, it composites the talent on top. And if I just zoom in once more, we have a look around the face here. I'll turn off Matte Refine again. So there's the unrefined edge. And that's where it turned on. So it's super handy and really quick. And all of this masking is done inside of the Pixel Chooser inside of the Continuum effect. If you'd like to learn more about this feature, please leave a comment, or you can visit the Boris Effects website where you can download a free trial version of Continuum as well. For now, this is John. See you in the next tutorial.